So let's start, guys. First of all, welcome you all to our webinar on Empower your workforce with Copilot for Microsoft 365. And thank you so much for all of your time that you are giving to us. So we are good to start now. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Abhishek Kushwaha. I'm a Microsoft certified trainer. I have more than 8 years of experience working with different Microsoft technologies. I have started working in the production. I have worked more than 5 years in the production, and gradually and slowly I have moved on to training. And these are some of my badges. I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, as well as I'm a technical champ for Copilot for M365. Additionally, these are some more badges, enterprise security badges, identity. I'm certified on all these technologies. So that's all about me. So let's start for today's session. Before we'll begin our today's session, let's understand what's the agenda for today. So what we are going to discuss for today. So today we will be going to discuss about two different modules to be precise. The first module, we will try to understand what is Copilot. We'll try to understand what is Copilot, what are the different terms we have in Copilot. Just to take an example, what is LLM or what is Microsoft Graph? We will try to understand from the basics. And in case, this will be the first module that we are talking about. And once we will move on to the second module, you all must be using multiple applications on day-to-day basis, just 365 applications. Let's say your Word, Excel, PowerPoint. So how Copilot can help you in those applications, how you can use those applications over there. So that's the agenda for today's topic. Let's start with the first thing first, learning path number one. Okay. And in case if you have guys have any question for me, put in the chat. I will take in that at the end of this webinar. So let's talk about introduction to Copilot for M365. So in this topic, we will try to understand what is Copilot, what are different components we have in Copilot, and once you will be using Copilot, what is the different responsible AI practices, how Microsoft is committed to provide you. Okay. So yeah, let's start with Copilot. First of all, Microsoft Copilot is like a smart friend who's always ready to help you. It's powered by artificial intelligence, which means it can understand what you are saying and help you work more efficiently. It can even make your work more enjoyable. Copilot uses something called large language model to understand your request and give helpful responses. Also uses data from Microsoft Graph, which is a service that provides access to data within M365. So these makes Copilot responses even more relevant to your work and your organization. So Copilot works well with Microsoft 365 application that you use every day, whether it's the team apps you use, whether you use Word, Outlook, PowerPoint, Excel, any application that you use on the day-to-day basis. It can do things like summarizing a long thread in Outlook, turning a text-heavy slide into clear bullet point in PowerPoint. How? We will see the demo in upcoming slides. We'll go to it. And how there are more things Copilot can do, like rewriting a paragraph in a different tone or style in Words. It can summarize the meeting and chat thread in Teams. So in simple terms, Copilot for M365 is like a smart coworker who's always there to help you work more efficiently, and you will find more creativity over there once you will save the time. So moreover, Copilot is deeply rooted into your organization data, and it is committed to maintaining high standard of security, privacy for you. So it operates with real-time access to your content with Microsoft Graph, which allows it to generate responses that are closely tied to your business content, providing relevance, answers, and insights. It works with your ongoing work context. In the meeting that you are currently in, might be if you have recently exchanged any emails or last week chat conversation, this will allow Copilot to deliver precise, relevant, and context-aware responses for you. Furthermore, Copilot is built on Microsoft's comprehensive approach to security, compliance, and privacy. Since it is integrated into Microsoft 365, it automatically aligns with your company robust security, privacy policies and processes for you. And one, how to use the Copilot, you must all be thinking about it. What are the different licenses requirements? So to use Copilot, you will need to meet the following requirements. What are the requirements you will require? First of all, you have to be M360, you require M365 subscription. You must either have E3, E5 for enterprise, A3, A5 for faculty, Microsoft 365 Business Standard or Business Premium licenses. Additionally, you require a Microsoft Intra ID account. So you will need an account based on Microsoft Intra for authentication. Additionally, you require OneDrive account. You have to ensure that OneDrive account is set up to follow Copilot to collaborate on the content so that you can restore, you can do more about it. So you require OneDrive and new Outlook for Windows. So the integration with Copilot requires a new Outlook for Windows. Once you have these prerequisites in places, you will be all set to use Copilot. Additionally, don't forget about the Copilot licenses. Once you have all these, you can purchase the Copilot license and you are good to go. You can use the Copilot on the day-to-day basis. But once, how you can, let's talk about how we can explore how Copilot for Microsoft 365 works. So Copilot is an intelligent partner that enhances your productivity across various Microsoft 365 applications. So how it works basically, understanding context and the user need. So Copilot analyzes content like document, emails, meeting, discussions to understand your intent and the meaning behind it. It leverages your work data in Microsoft 365 to provide any additional content. And once we are up to it, we can use search and retrieval. Copilot uses powerful search capabilities to find relevant data and the content source for you, all with your natural language. You can use your own language and it will give it to you. Natural phrasing with LLM. So large language model enables Copilot to generate naturally phrased recommendations for you with unique situations. And always the quality always matters. Copilot evaluates and refines suggestions for relevant outputs for you. And there are other key capabilities, like Copilot can keep you engaged in meeting and provide catch-ups for the missed one, if you have any. It can summarize the lengthy email thread for and draft responses for you. It can help you draft, edit, summarize, and document the creation for you. And simplify starting presentation using your own natural language. And it can identify trends, provide recommendation to you. It can ensure the data protection and enterprise controls. So you decide which AI suggestion to use, modify or discard it. So if I have to summarize this, Copilot transforms how employees work by understanding the context, taking actions and offering the valuable features for you. Let's try to understand how it works. So you must all be thinking how Copilot works. What's the logical architecture behind it? So this, if you will see this illustration or a picture, Copilot follows a sophisticated process to provide relevant and actionable responses for you. So it starts with you, user. So when you ask a question within an app, it could be any app. It could be Teams app. It could be Word, PowerPoint, Excel, Outlook, your day-to-day applications. So Copilot uses Microsoft draft data to make your question more specific. It also considers user data and relevant sources to refine the query further. And based on the refined question, Copilot generates an initial answer using the large language model for you. But further refinement is needed. So using Microsoft Draft, Copilot verifies against relevant data. And there always would be a responsible AI practices, which ensures ethical and responsible content would be there. And we should not forget about security at any point. So Copilot also takes care of the security and compliance, and it ensures data protection. And finally, Copilot provides a relevant, actionable suggestion right to your organization data. So I have to summarize this. Copilot transform your data, in your input into helpful output using all these things. But you all must be thinking, Abhishek, you are talking about LLM and all those things. How it can be helpful for me? What is LLM? Let's try to understand what is LLM. Let's explore some of the foundational element that powers Copilot. By delving into these core concepts, you can gain a clear understanding of the processes that enable Copilot to offer its insightful recommendations and suggestions for you. First of all, LLM. LLM are a type of artificial intelligence that are really good at understanding and creating text that sounds like it was written by human. They are called large because they have a lot of parameters that they are trained on a lot of data. This is something like a model's brain cell. And LLM, like you must be using ChatGPT, are a type of AI that can create the new content for you. This is different from other type of AI that just make prediction or categorizes things. When LLM are used with text, they can create responses that makes sense based on the prompts they are given. So in the case of Copilot, LLMs are the engines that powers it. And these models are privately hosted by Microsoft Azure OpenAI services. So Copilot uses these models to understand what you are asking, and it will create the relevant response. This will help you work more effectively and ensure your data is kept private and secure. So Microsoft 365 keeps your data separate and secure. This means your data is kept private while it's being processed and as well as while it has been stored. And how it usually works, how it understands you using NLP. What is NLP? Natural Language Processing. It's a type of artificial intelligence that helps computer understand and responds to human language. It's like the brain behind the Copilot, helping in reading, understanding, and creating text just like a human would. So how does it work? There are a few terms behind it. Tokenization. So let's break down. So this will break down text into smaller parts, like words or phrases. It's like turning a big, complex phrases into smaller and easier to understand pieces. We have semantic analysis. This means this will help Copilot understand the meaning or context of your text that you have given it. It's like helping Copilot read between the lines. We have semantic analysis. This will help Copilot understand the mood or emotion behind the text. It's like helping Copilot understand not just what you are saying, but how you are feeling. And language translation would be there. So this will help Copilot assist user in different languages. It's like having a translator that can help Copilot understand and respond to user all over the world. If I have to summarize the NLP, NLP is like the brain that helps Copilot for Microsoft 365 understand and respond to you effectively. So it bridges the gap between human language and machine understanding for you. And always there would be an application, 365 application that would be using like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and all such things, Office suites. So that's how these are the core components of Copilot. There are more. There are two more we will be talking, Microsoft Graph. So Microsoft Graph is like a big web that connects all your Microsoft 365 services and data. It's used by Copilot to search and bring together content from different sources within your organization. So Microsoft Graph API helps Copilot understand more about you by bringing information from your email, from your chat, from your documents, from your meeting. This includes data from services. What we have services? We have Outlook, we have OneDrive, we have SharePoint, we have Teams, there are more. So instead of you having to switch between different apps or navigate away, Microsoft Graph will bring you all the relevant information to you to Copilot. And you don't have to worry about it. It's secure. Copilot only uses information that you have permission to access it. and it follows all the data securely and the compliance policies of Microsoft 365. If I have to summarize the graph, it's like a big web that connects all your data, and Copilot is like a smart assistant that uses web to you to find the information you need. And Copilot we were talking about, it's like a smart assistant that uses a chat format to interact with you. This makes it feels like you are having a natural conversation, and it helps Copilot understand the context of what you are asking. And again, let's recap. Copilot uses large language model, which are a type of artificial intelligence that understand and generate the text. It uses these models along with the information from your business data and apps to understand your prompts and provide the relevant insights for you. So in simple terms, Copilot is like a smart assistant that you can chat with. It understands your prompt and uses information from your apps to give you more helpful and the relevant insights about it. So this is what Copilot does. This is just architecture, a simple architecture of how Copilot works. But again, if you are going to use Copilot, you must be thinking how secure it is. It must be coming to your mind. So be responsible when working with AI. So Microsoft has begun responsible AI journey way back in 2017 already. So Microsoft has begun working with AI journey way back in 2017. Microsoft believes that the development and deployment AI must be guided by the creation of an ethical framework. And therefore, in 2018, they have set up 6 core principles to work around AI. What are the 6 principles? The first, fairness. Second, we have reliability and safety. Privacy and security, inclusiveness, transparency, accountability. So let's have a small idea of what does this means. The fairness is basically Microsoft aims to eliminate the biases, ensuring equal treatment for all the users, and reliability and safety should be there. So they promote rigorous testing, ensures Microsoft AI performs with safety. And privacy and security should be there. So your data is protected. Your data is your data. It should be protected, both in the training and the post-deployment phases. So Microsoft places a premium on safeguarding your details. Inclusiveness should be there. AI tools are crafted to be accessible and beneficial for everyone, regardless of your physical ability, gender, ethnicity, country, or anything. It should be available for everyone. And once you are using AI, the transparency should be there. Microsoft believes in keeping user informed about how its AI system works and their intended purposes behind it. And once you are using all this application, all those tools of Microsoft, accountability should be there. So ethical and legal standards are at the forefront, with AI developer and designer held accountable for their creations. And for every step, Microsoft has different tools and everything to safeguard you. So you are ready, you are going to use it. Now, we understand some basic part of it, how Copilot works, what is the logical architecture behind it, so how you should be using responsible AI. But again, what are the different tools we have? Okay, so there is a summary that we have already discussed so far. So this ends our module number 1. Now let's start with module number 2, exploring the possibilities with Copilot for Microsoft 365. Now, so in this section, we will be talking about how we can compose and summarize documents with Copilot in Word, summarizing and drafting email with Copilot in Outlook, designing captivating presentation with Copilot in PowerPoint, analyzing transform Copilot in Excel, and Microsoft Copilot with graph grounded data. All these applications you must be using, all of you must be using on day-to-day basis. Let's start with the first one. First one, Microsoft Word. So Copilot is a feature that in Microsoft Word that makes creating and refining document easier. Help with drafting new content, improving the existing text, and summarizing the lengthy article for you. You can use Copilot to indicate a document by providing brief prompt. So let's try to do a small demo. Let me bring it my browser over here and I'll see how it works. Let me open the Word so that we can do some demo now. So this is my Word document. All of you must be familiar with this. So just to use Copilot, we have two options. One of them is draft with Copilot, and the other one over here, we have Copilot right over here. So let's say I am over here, Copilot. I want to draft something. Let's say I need to, I'm a fan of baseball. So I need to summarize something. Summarize about baseball. Or might be I have to give a presentation or something like that. I have to create. So instead of you starting from the scratch, Microsoft Copilot will do it for you. So see what it started doing? With just a single prompt, it started drafting me all those information for me. What is baseball? What is baseball played? What equipment has been used in baseball? What were some famous baseball terms and players over there? I can keep it, but I'm not happy with this. I want to compare this with football. Summarize about baseball so I can edit it. Let me show you that one. So at the bottom, I have one draft with me. This is called draft. I have one draft with me. At the bottom, this box comes up. As of now, I have created one draft, and what the prompt I have given, if I'm happy with this draft, I can keep it. I can regenerate with the same prompt. I can discard it. Let me generate one. Summarize about baseball versus football. Now you can see this single prompt, everything has been changed for me. Instead of me doing all those research and everything, I can simply read, okay, this has been something done. I can just read out, I can change it. I can do what I want. In case if I want to compare with previous prompt, can I have the option? Yes. In that case, I do have the option. I can change the tone and everything according to myself. I can give the Copilot prompt, okay, change the tone, and Microsoft Copilot will do it for me. It keeps on generating for me. You can see all those Copilot versus football summarization and everything with that. I can regenerate it. I can discard it again, the same thing, football and the baseball again. You must be thinking, Abhishek, okay, you are using this. What about this Copilot? Yes, you can also, let's say if it is doing so, I have any question related to these field or might be, so I can always go and ask over here, summarize the document, or I can ask any question related to this document. Let it get done. Let me stop it for now. So now in case if I need to compare the previous and this one, yes. Previous draft is also over here, and I have this draft with me. I have both the draft with me. Let's say I am happy with this draft, but I need to add something. I want to fine tune it, but I do not. I'm happy with the draft, but I want to add something. Instead of me giving the prompt directly, I can use this box in this case. I can simply give a prompt something like add this one, and Microsoft Copilot will add in the draft eventually. And again, I can use it. Once I am happy with it, I can keep it. I can regenerate it. I can discard it. Let's say I'm happy with this. I can keep it. Now you can see it's a normal document for now. You all must be thinking, Abhishek, can I ask, you told me that we can summarize the document. Yes, let me show you this one. Whatever it has been written, I want to summarize in over there. So now with just a single click, or with a single prompt, I can ask Copilot to generate whatever I want from it. Okay. It has been done. I can copy it, I can paste it over here. But again, this is for the existing document. You must be thinking, what about the external content? Can I ask something else? So I love cheesecakes. Let's ask something about the cheesecake. Let's ask, can you provide a recipe for a classic cheesecake? But again, this is not part of the document. What Microsoft Copilot will do in this case? Will it generate the answer? Yes, it will generate the answer. But again, it will give you a disclaimer as well. What disclaimer it will give you? The response is not based on this document, but it will give you the answer. It will give you all the answers. But again, one more question before we move on to the next topic. You all must be thinking, Abhishek, you have drafted from the zero. What happens if I have already a document that is stored in somewhere in my OneDrive? I want to refer to that. I want to ask a question to that. Can I? Yes. In that case, you can reference a document. Let's say you have any document that is stored somewhere. Let's say Graphic Design Institute I have. And I can ask, okay, summarize this for me. Or any other thing, it's up to you how you give the prompt. The more prompt you will give it, the more information you'll give it. So see, this is stored in my OneDrive. I have just given a file to it and it has started giving me all those information. Okay, so that is what we have discussed about Word. Yes, we have discussed about this as well. The ribbon that is on the left-hand side, you can all use this. Now next, we have Outlook as well. So now we have discussed about Word. What about the Outlook? Your Outlook is the one of the famous application you all must be using on day-to-day basis. Let's say I have some important email for this one. Let's say I have important email. Instead of me going through the large or long email, I can simply ask Copilot to summarize it for you. So that should be on the top. So see, this is what Copilot has. This person has said this. Or let's say if I have some other email, Copilot will go ahead and generate from you. It will summarize the long thread for me. Instead of me going through one by one, it will ask me. But again, you all must be thinking, Abhishek, what happens if I will draft a new email? Can Copilot help me? Yes, let's see how it help you. This is how I have created the new. Right now, I'm over here. Now, I want Copilot to help me. Write with Copilot. I want write an email about, let's say, annual meeting. So again, there is just at the bottom, there is a generation option. Whether you want the tone to be direct, neutral, casual, formal, it's up to you how you want to keep it. Let's say if you are sending it to somebody in your organization, you want to keep it formal. But I want this to be a lengthy one. The more refined prompt you will give it, the more information you will receive. Okay, let me generate it for you. Copilot in Outlook makes managing email easier, letting you focus more on effective communication. It helps you understanding the long email thread, see different viewpoints, and spot any unanswered question for you. See, this I have with me. But again, annual function is stated to be on 15th of October. No, I want it to be, I am happy with this draft. I can regenerate it, I can discard it, I can keep it. But again, I have seen, okay, this is the date I do not want. I only want to change the date. I can change, okay. Let the annual meeting is on July 1st. So instead of me going to regenerate the entire graph, okay, I have to refresh it. Sometime it happens. Well, in that time, just refresh the page and try it again. Again, it happens due to some, might be browser issues or something. Copilot can generate, but it can generate. Or else if it is not generating, you always have an option to rewrite it. Write an email about annual meeting that is taking place on July 1st. Let's try this time. See, the date has been changed. Again, in case if I want to keep it longer, make it longer. It is shorter, I want to make it longer. Yes. With a single click, Copilot started working for you. I want to make it sound more formal. Okay. So the more information, the more prompt you will give it, the more information you are going to get it. See, I can keep it, I can discard it. This is now send. It's okay to send me. I can put in a CC, I can send it to somebody in my organization. It's up to me. So that's how you can use Copilot on day-to-day functionality. And we have PowerPoint. So there are more ways, there are more things we can discuss. But due to time constraint, let's discuss a few more things. PowerPoint. Okay. What about those who are in sales or training or some other field? They must be using PowerPoint day-to-day basis. Let's say I'm starting with a blank presentation. I need, in case if I have to manually create it, everything over here, it will take more time, might be more hour, might be days to create it. So Copilot is here to rescue. All you can do is just ask the Copilot, create a presentation about, let's say, hiking or maybe traveling. So all of you must feel love traveling. Even I love traveling. So create a presentation about traveling. Yes, So we have created presentation about traveling. But just a single prompt, Copilot will start working for you. Depending upon what the prompt you are giving, it might take a minute or so. Yeah, see, if I have to create all this presentation, it might take more than that. But again, there are designers for you. In case if you want to design it, how you want to keep it, it's to you. And you can, at the bottom, there are some pictures, you can use it. But I'm not happy with this. I want to add a slide about agenda. Let's say add and slide about agenda. So with a single prompt, you can ask Copilot to create a new slide and add an agenda behind it. See, Microsoft has created us agenda. Again, but I'm not happy with this. I want to add an image, let's say, add an image of a lake. This is something completely white. I want to add an image of the lake over here. I have just given a prompt. See, Microsoft Copilot has given it for you. That's how Copilot can infuse you with vibrancy with your presentation. Again, it can do more than that. And once you have in Excel, let's say if you are using Excel. So an Excel Copilot for Microsoft 365 is your data analysis companion, making complex data set easy to understand. You no longer need to master complicated formulas. Just talk to Copilot like you talk to a colleague, your friend. So Copilot can help you find patterns, explore if scenarios, or get new formula suggestions for you. It can help you exploring your data without changing the spots, friend. Create the visuals for you. It can help you for the recommendations. It can analyze your data. So let's try that as well. Let's say if I am in Excel, let me bring in Excel for you. Here we have. We have in Copilot. Yeah. So again, you can see Copilot written over here. That's in ribbon. Now I do not have any data. Let me bring some data for you so that we can try and test those data in the Copilot. Yeah, we have an example. Try an example. So I have some data with me. But again, I want to check, are there any outliers in my data? Let me check. Just the single prompts, you can start asking Copilot, are there any outlier in my data? By the time it is analyzing it, you can see has generated me budget and outliers for me. I can add to a new sheet. Can I see another site? Yes, I can too. But let's say if you have the launching date over here, you can see 27, 29, 3rd Feb, and again 16 January. I want to short the date. Can Copilot short the date? Yes, let's give the information. Short a date by launch date. Let's see how Copilot will work for you. Okay, 316, it has been done for you. Again, I'm not happy with this color. I want to change the table style to something little gray. Can I do? Change the table style to little gray. Yeah, see, with just a single prompt, Copilot can do more than that. Okay, so let's quickly go to Copilot with graph grounded chat. Again, how you can use the Copilot. First of all, you can use Copilot on your browser, bing.com/chat. You can use copilot.microsoft.com and you can sign up with your intra-ID credential once you have access to. You can refer to all those emails, chat, meetings, and everything. Meanwhile, I'm logging in. Bear with me. It will hardly take 20 seconds. So I'm now logged in into my Copilot. So with a single prompt, I can attach, I can ask people about it. I can use the files. I can use the meeting. Let's say if I have a Teams meeting and I want to ask a question related to that. Yes. I can ask, okay, what is discussed in the meeting? With a single prompt, Copilot will give me, okay, this has been discussed in the meeting. You can ask as many questions as you have. You can, if you have emails, yes, you can refer to a particular emails over there. And once you have in the web, let's say at the top, there are two, work and the web option. Once you are in the web, once you are using Copilot, you have three options, creative, balanced, and precise for you. So what is creative? Creative is basically this style provide responses that are more imaginative and creative for you. It's ideal for a user who wants to explore different possibilities and generate the new ideas for you. We have balanced over here as well. So balanced means this style provide responses that are longer, more prescriptive. It's ideal for a user who want a balance between precision and creativity. You have precise as well. Precise. So this style provide shorter, more search focused answers. It's ideal for users who want quick and accurate answers to their queries. And only not these application, you can use more application. Like in case if you are into, you can use Loop. So Loop is a collaborative space where you can collaborate with your team at the same time. So how you can use Copilot in Loops? With a single click. Let's say I'm creating a new workspace for interview questions, and I can tag my team member. Let's say I'm working in HR field and I have to conduct an interview for 10 people in my organization. So what I will do, I will create a new workspace. I can add my team members over here. Once I have added team member, there are some more details. Let's say I am not adding it over here. I have you can edit all those documents at the same time, and you can use Copilot as well. Let me use, let's say, create 10 question for system admin. So if in case me and my team members are going to conduct the interview, they have these questions ready with them. So they can ask the question. They can, in case they want to change the questions, they will change it and I will see it as well. So it's a collaborative space. We both can work at the same time. And I can ask Copilot to change the question. I can ask Copilot to rewrite the question. With a single thing, I have those questions ready with me. And once somebody have access at the top, you can see those names as well. Okay, so that's it. So we have discussed about a few things about Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, Excel, and Copilot, and what's the opportunity we have. So according to a survey done by WTI, Work Trend Index, 65% of employees don't feel they have the right skill, but still they are seeing trend from early Copilot user that shows an average of 1.2 hours of time has been saved on day-to-day basis. So using Copilot, you can save a lot of time so that you can use those time for your creativity. And this is just not us saying this, is just not Microsoft is saying. Dentsu, a world-leading creative media agency, is seeing real results. Using Viva, along with employee survey data, to assess the impact of their Copilot for M365 deployment on engagement and productivity. This is some of the key findings they got. 15 to 30 minutes. So Copilot for M365 users are saving 15 to 30 minutes a day, and 12% increase in one-to-one time with direct reports among Copilot users. This is a lot of time if you calculate in months or in year on year-to-year basis. And user has also experienced an 18% increase in uninterrupted hour. So time savings are the biggest benefit reported by Copilot user, along with positive changes in employee collaboration and behavior patterns. And this is, again, in case if you want to check it, let me put the link in the chat so that you can double verify this. Meanwhile, I'm putting this article for them so that you can verify it. That's all for today, guys. In case if you have any question for me, put in the chat. I will be happy to answer. Otherwise, in case if you want to learn more about it, you can contact Nicholas related to this. In case if you want to learn more anything, any questions related to Copilot. So yeah, Samsung has asked Copilot create a pivot table using Excel. Yes, Copilot can create pivot table using Excel. Has any more questions? Yes, it's your forum, guys. Use it. Ask me as many questions you have. Meanwhile, I have just sent you. Yeah. when we have this session recorded, Nicholas will be able to answer this question for you. And for the other one, do Copilot saves our question for future reference? No. Copilot for M365, Copilot for M365 does not save your chat interactions for you. And can you create PowerPoint presentation from Excel file? Yes, we can create PowerPoint presentation from Excel file. Yes, definitely. And Prithvi has asked, can we create PPTs from any file or Word which is already related to project? Yes, definitely you can create it. Yes, definitely. Let's try this. So you want me to refer a PPT? Yes, let me go with the PPT. And you want me to, let me start from the scratch. So everybody should be on the same page. So you want to create a presentation from a file? Yes, let's try this. So again, I'm starting from scratch. I have Copilot in my ribbon. You can click on this and create a presentation from file. And I have the file suggestion with me. In case if you can see all those files, Editum, Fivefear, Fabricam, all those files over here. All these files are in my OneDrive. Let's say if I'm not finding the file, somebody must be asking, okay, Abhishek, I'm not finding my files over here. How can I use it? Let's say I'm not finding all those files. I have checked the suggestions and I'm not finding over there. In that case, go to OneDrive. Let's say I am going to my files, my folder, and I want to refer to this. So what I will do is I will simply go ahead and copy the link and I will simply go to my presentation. Not this, where is the presentation? It's over here. And I will simply paste it over here. Okay. Let me double check it. Copy. Okay. Now it has been copied. Let me paste it again. So somebody must be asking. Now I have this. See, created a presentation from this file. I'm not finding it. I have simply gone over there. And so you're asking me create a PPT from Excel table. Let me try. Okay. So this is the Excel table I'm referring to. This is the Excel table. Let me see if I have. So this is the Excel table. Sayed, this is Excel table we are referring. I'm creating the presentation only from, it looks like the reference on the sheet to print. Try using a Word or PDF document. Okay, it's asking me to use another platform, that is Word. Do any of interaction get saved or once we close the application to clear it? See, no. Until unless, let's say if I have created a presentation like something like this, until unless you will save it, by default, all the presentation and all these things is auto getting saved. But for the chat, no, Microsoft Copilot is not saving or not referring to this for LLM. But in case if you want to, let's say if I am the Copilot, let's say if I am in the work, in the recent activity, you will find it. You can refer it from here. No, Sayed, not from the Excel file for now. Yeah. Has any more questions? Yes. Vijay, yeah. So do you have any interaction saved? No. Not interaction saved in Copilot is something like you can save it, but again, those is for these interactions that are getting saved. If you're asking if they are referring to that, then no. Thank you, Nicholas. So, and guys, another webinar is starting in 10 minutes. In case if you guys are looking for something new for creating Azure AI document intelligence solutions, feel free to join over there. If we can, we use Copilot to generate flowcharts. Okay, you can all, yeah. In case if you have any, yes, let's say if you have any something like that, let's say if you are not finding answer, you can always refer to this one. Let's ask Copilot. Let's see what reference it gives. Can we use Copilot to generate flowcharts? And again, you can also use Copilot using your intra-ID account anytime. Okay. Copilot assists with generating content based on data provided, including flowcharts. It is shedding. And additionally, there is the reference it is giving in my organization. In case if I want to refer to the web part, let me again type it. Go ahead. Yes, Sayed, regarding the extensibility, not this session. Actually, this session is about exploring the possibilities with Copilot. In the extensibility, yes, we offer training to learn extensibility options as well, where we talk about plugins, graph connector, and all those things. But again, not in this session. And in case if you want, if you are interested in the training, yes, Nicholas can help you. Nicholas, can you please put your email over there? So in case Sayed has want to reach out to you related to any question related to training as such. Thank you so much. Vijay, can Copilot write a programming code on our explanation? You can get, see, Copilot, you can use GitHub for Copilot for writing the codes. Yes, Christy? Yes. Guys, the forum is open. Anything?
Thank you for that session, Abhishek. It was a lovely session, as usual. It was lovely to have you. And thank you, everyone, for joining as well. Hope you've enjoyed the session and found your queries to your solutions. If anybody wants to have this training with us, I've shared my email. If anybody wants to have this training, you can... Oh, sorry, my mic was off. If anybody wants to have this training with us, I've shared my email. Kindly forward me the details so that our expert can get back to you with the required details. And kindly do fill in your attendance sheets for your webinar settings. Thank you, everyone, for joining. And Abhishek, we have another 4 to 5 minutes left for this webinar. You can have the Q&A. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Nicholas, for your input. Thank you, Peter, for giving us the time. Lovely to have you. Thank you, Teru. Thank you, MS. Nicholas can help you regarding the certificate. Nicholas, can you answer this question? The certificate for attending the session?
Yes, Abhishek. So you'll receive a mail after you fill the attendance sheet. You'll receive a mail from our side in which you'll be receiving our login details of our portal or of our LET, that is Learning Enhancement Tool. So you have to log in with those credentials and download your webinar certificates. I hope it is clear. I got a few queries regarding that. So I'll repeat. After you fill the form, after you fill the attendance form, which I've circulated in the webinar, you'll be receiving a mail from our side. So in that mail, you'll have to log in. You'll receive a login detail. So you have to log in with those login details and download the site. Thank you, Abhishek.